All right, now this is interesting. First of all, let me show you Ephesians 5, verse 13. But all things that are reproved are made manifest by the light, for whatsoever does make manifest is light. So let's take a look at the NASB, the New American Standard Bible. It says, "But all things become visible when they are exposed by the light. For everything that becomes visible is light." Now let me ask you, when sin becomes visible, is sin therefore light? No, that's wrong. That's very wrong. All right, so let me show you something here. Take a listen to this.
Would you and Ann come out and spend some weeks with us, and we'll work on a feasibility report. I can pick up the copyright to the 1901 if it seems advisable. Well, up till that time, I thought the Westcott and Hart was the text. You're intelligent if you believe in the Westcott and Hart. Some of the finest people in the world believe in that Greek text. The finest leaders we have today. You'd be surprised. If I told you, you wouldn't believe it. They haven't gone into it just as I hadn't gone into it, just taking for granted. But at any rate, we went out. We started on a feasibility report, and I encouraged him to go ahead with it. I'm afraid I'm in trouble with the Lord. I encouraged him to go ahead with it. We laid the groundwork. I wrote the format. I helped to interview some of the translators. I sat with the translators. I wrote the preface. When you see the New American Standard, they're my words. Well, when I got my copy, I got one of the 50 deluxe copies that were printed. Mine was number 7, blue, light blue cover. But it was a big, rather big, and I couldn't carry it with me. And I never really looked at it. I just took for granted it was done as we started it, you know, until some of my friends across the country began to learn that I had some part in it, and they started saying, "What about this? What about this?" Especially Dr. David Otis Fuller in Grand Rapids. I've known him for 35 years. He'd say, he always called me Frank, I called him Duke. He said, "Frank, what about this? You had part in it. What about this? What about this?" Well, first of all, wait a minute. Let's don't go overboard. Let's don't be too pretty. You know how you justify yourself the last minute. I got the place. I said to Ann, "I'm in trouble. I can't refute these arguments. It's wrong. It's terribly wrong. It is frightfully wrong. And what am I going to do about it?" Well, I went through heart search, some real soul searching for about 4 months. I don't know. I think about 4 months. And I sat down and wrote the most difficult letter of my life, I think. And I wrote to my friend Dewey, and I said, "Dewey, I don't want to add to your problems. Lost his wife some 3 years ago. I was there for the funeral. Doctor had made a mistake in operating on a cataract. He lost the sight of one eye and then had to have an operation on the other. Had a slight heart attack, had sugar diabetes, man 74 years of age. But I wrote and said, I can no longer ignore these criticisms I'm hearing, and I can't refute them. The only thing I could do, and dear brother, I have nothing against you, and I can witness at the judgment seat of Christ and before men wherever go that you were 100% sincere." He's not a translator. He's not schooled in language or anything. He's just a businessman. He did the promoting. He had the money. He did the promoting. So I said, he did it conscientiously. He wanted absolutely right. He thought it was right. I guess nobody pointed out some of these things to him when it was finished. But nevertheless, I said, "I must, under God, renounce every attachment to the New American Standard." I have the copy of the letter. In fact, I have his letter. Showed it to some people. The Robert saw it. Mike saw it. Stating that he was bowled over, that he was shocked beyond words. Said that's putting it mildly. But he said, "I'll write to you in a few weeks. And I still love you. To me, you're going to be Franklin, my friend, throughout the course." And he said, "I'll write you in 3 weeks. But he won't write me now. He was to be married. Sent us an invitation to come to the reception. Standing in the courtroom, I mean in the county court by the desk, the clerk said, 'What is your full name, sir?' And he said, 'Franklin Dewey.' And that's the last word he spoke on this earth. So he was buried 2 days before he was supposed to be married, and he's with the Lord. He loves the Lord. He knows different now. But I tell you, dear people, somebody's going to have to stand. And no matter if you stand against everyone else, stand. Don't get obnoxious. Don't argue. There's no sense in arguing. But nevertheless, that's where the New American Standard stands in connection with the Authorized Version. Now, let me... I just jotted these down. Put me to show you just what these many versions, paraphrases, and translations are doing. They cause